Dear Chairman, dear colleagues, it's a great pleasure for me to be part of this important session and timely session dedicated to COVID-19. I have nothing to declare. Was clear since the beginning that the huge efforts to combat the COVID-19 pandemic are understandable, but we must not forget our primary obligation to look after our patients. Their needs should not be neglected. And despite increasing recognition that the pre-existing cardiac disease is associated with poor outcomes in the general population, the impact of the COVID-19 infection on patients with CHD was unknown at the beginning. And for that reason, everybody since the beginning understand that the key was to collect data. But where to find data about our patients? One of the first centers that started to collect information around Europe was the ECDC, the European Center for Disease Prevention and Control, an agency of the European Union that uses multiple information sources per country, like Ministry of Health, National Public Health Institutes, going through websites or official accounts of Twitter, Facebook. All the data collected were and are systematically cross-checked with data from the WHO. This data give us a very nice and easy to evaluate overview of the incidence of new cases and the fatality ratio in specific countries, in specific areas of the world. In this specific case, this screenshot give you an overview of what is going on a couple of weeks ago in Europe, in the different countries. All these data are still affected by the local testing strategy, laboratory capacity, and the effectiveness of surveillance systems. One other data source that is very friendly for the user is the dashboard of the Johns Hopkins University and Foundation that give us a overview around the globe, but also the possibility to go through specific areas like these two cartoons dedicated to Europe, and information about case fatality ratio, information about death per 100,000 population. All this information, all this data, give us the possibility to calculate a cumulative world fatality rate of 2.2%. It is clear that there are considerably differences in terms of location. What is going on in Brazil, of course, is completely different to what is going on in Australia. But if you look at what is going on all around the globe, the mortality fatality rate is about 2.2. This is an important information. Again, this data source give us also the possibility to check the overview of different countries in terms of new cases, also the impact of the immunization with the vaccine in the different countries. But according to the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention in U.S., it is clear that now the number of people, at least in the U.S., dying of COVID-19 is declining. But this is an important information. If you have an existing heart condition, you are still more likely to become severely ill if you became infected. all this information may be used, may be part of publication. This publication focalizes their attention on specific heart condition that are the most spread situation experienced by the general population. But if you want to get information about CHD patients, is a little bit more difficult because frequently this group of diseases are part of the other circulatory disease. So difficult to extrapolate this information. The first paper that gave us some insight of the our population was this Italian paper that was produced in Italy, because during the first wave, our country was very severe hit by the infection. So we were able to collect a lot of data in a very short period of time. It was clear, first of all, that not just adult with CHD, but also pediatric patients were involved with some complication correlated to the infection, like palpitation and arrhythmias, chest pain, myocardial injury, heart failure, and etc. This paper so give us, first of all, the first insight, an important message that discussing about congenital patient, we should go through all the age spectrum of this heart condition. Another important paper that help us to evaluate the data information was done matching two different words, congenital heart disease and COVID-19, or congenital heart disease and SARS-CoV-2 on PubMed. These authors were able to collect 94 patients, most of them in adult age, with a death incidence of 1.2%, a very optimistic incidence that was lower than the general population incidence. But this paper didn't include another paper that was published more or less at the same time, that was a singular one-center experience in US. They were able to collect 53 patients, most of them again in adult age. 9 of these patients, 7 adults, had moderate up to severe symptoms. The symptoms were more or less the same that the symptoms encountered in the general population. What it was important to observed was that the duration of symptoms were high in terms of day in patient where the ventricular function was abnormal than patient with normal ventricular function. The died patient were 3, all of them adults, with an incidence that were about 1.6%. Because of all this data, the European Society of Cardiology Working Group decided to create a task force to go in through all this information in order to create a pathway to follow and to stratify the risk of our patient in a more personalized way. But it was a consensus paper. It was just a roadmap. What was important was this paper that was published as a first paper, giving us insight about specific information on the outcome of our patient. These authors were able to collect information of 100 five patients around Europe in 25 different centers. And the number of patients died were 5 for a fatality case rate of 4.7%. That was the double of the general population. Important information, all these paper, all these patients had very complex pathophysiological problems with severe comorbidities, one through up to three comorbidities that can affect quite a lot the evolution. But I believe that the paper that till now give us more information is this paper that was published some weeks ago. This is an important paper that taken into consideration more than 1,000 patients around the globe in 58 different centers. And what was important to get from this paper? First of all, that the most important risk factors are related not to the underlying anatomical condition, but to the pathophysiology of the patient, like the presence of cyanosis, prior heart failure admission, supplemental oxygen use, or pulmonary arterial hypertension. And if you go through the case fatality ratio from COVID-19 was 2.3, so the same than the general population. But if you go through the specific condition, you see that there's a Menger physiology, the cyanotic patient, the patient with PAH are the most affected patients. So in conclusion, what we were able to get from this paper. First of all, that the mortality in a patient, most of them, or I will say all of them in adult age, is commensurate with the general population. The most vulnerable patients are those with worse physiological stage, such as cyanosis and pulmonary hypertension. And the anatomic complexity does not appear to predict infection severity. Let me say as first thought that what we really learn till now is that without life has no price, sustained health has no as important cost, and we should push our health system to better organize in the future the management of serious illness, because the final cost can be higher if you delay it, regain on an active life in our society. I thanks all of you for your attention.